As tempting as it is, there are 10 reasons why you should not even deal with a narcissist after there's any kind of a breakup. Now, the temptation is to want to try to make sense of the relationship, have conversations with them, and they are going to try to lure you in like you have no idea. And maybe you do. Maybe you've already been subject to it, victim to it. But what you want to do is really have no contact. So before we begin, hit subscribe and then ring the bell so that you know when I have more content, more videos for you. Number one, I want you to have no contact because as soon as you have no contact, you are taking their power away. This is incredibly important with a narcissist or anyone who is in a toxic relationship. You want to get that power back because what you've been feeling is that you were powerless because they were sucking up your energy, your money, your love, whatever it was that you had, your self-esteem. They were taking everything from you. So by going no contact, they can't take anything else, okay? So you want to get your power back and you want to cut off the energy tie. Number two, I want you to focus on healing. I want you just to focus on just being and getting comfortable being in your own skin, looking in the mirror and liking who you see in the mirror and being proud of yourself for having no contact. Number three, a great reason to have no contact is that you're going to start seeing that person in their true light. So even if you are feeling overwhelmed with them, frustrated, you don't want them in your life, when you pull back a little bit and you see them more as the weak person that they are, you are going to feel so much better. Four, you're going to start to repair. You're going to start to get your resilience back. You're going to start to get more of your self-esteem back. You're going to feel more empowered. Five, when you go no contact, you start to refocus on your life. So yeah, you're going to think about the other person and it's going to be hard. I have other videos on that. I'll put a link below. But for the most part, you're going to be able to just refocus on you, what it is that you like, who you were before you met them, or who you are right now. Maybe this relationship was longer or very intense, and now you're in a new place. So this is going to be a great place for you to focus on you. Six, I want you to focus on your health. This is a great opportunity right now during no contact, right from the very beginning, to focus on your health. I want you to start working out. I want you to get blood work, see a doctor, see your naturopath. Whatever it is you need to do, start focusing on your health. Very different than self-care. We'll talk about that later. But your health is incredibly important right now. Number seven, this is where I want you to start focusing on mourning the relationship. So you're not really mourning that person, or maybe you are, but I want you to focus on just mourning that relationship. So when you mourn a relationship, you're going to go through different stages, sadness and anger and fear and denial and all of these different stages, and that's okay. You may have to go through them several times, but if you don't start, you're going to put yourself in a position where you're stuck in time. So I want you to go ahead and maybe get the book On Death and Dying by Elizabeth Kubler-Ross. That is a great book because it will, even though this person hasn't died, your relationship has died, and it will help you to understand the process of mourning a little bit more. So go ahead and allow yourself to be sad. Allow yourself to be angry. That is incredibly important for you to do. Number eight. Now, this is fantastic because this is going to give you some time to take a step back and really focus on what you do want. Now, you already know what you don't want. You already have known what you don't want since you've been with that person or that series of people who were narcissists. But now I want you to focus on what you do want, the standards that you will have in your relationship and the expectations you have in a partner. Nine. Now, we talked about this a little bit earlier. I want you to focus on self-care. Self-care is incredibly important, and self-care is more massages and maybe getting your nails done or just taking walks, leisurely walks, not for the focus of working out or health, but just to enjoy life. I want you to get together with friends. I want you to watch your favorite show on television. Any and all of the things that you had to put aside for that toxic person, I want you to bring them back into your life. Lastly, the best thing about no contact is as you go through the mourning process and as you start to add things back into your life, you're going to be able to step back and believe it or not, you're going to be able to get to a place where you can forgive. It doesn't mean you're going to forget, and I don't want you to forget, but I want you to get to that place where you can just sort of let go and move forward so that you're not stuck in that energy and that dynamic of that toxic person and that toxic relationship. You're going to extract yourself and move forward. So let's talk about what does it feel like to go no contact. At first, it's really hard and you're going to be thinking about the person all of the time, but I gave you some really great reasons to go no contact. Try to find three of those reasons. I hope you have all of them, but try to find three of those top reasons why you would want to go no contact and keep those on the top of your mind. Maybe write them down, whatever you need to do. I'm going to write them down below so you can check them out below. But also what I want you to do is hit subscribe and ring the bell so that you know when I bring more content to you. And definitely write something below if you have an idea for me that you would like me to help you with in the next video. All right, I will talk to you soon. Bye.